Crafters from St. Lucia and the Bahamas on Thursday, March 30th partook in a knowledge exchange program where participants learned about endemic plants and materials to use in their crafting processes. Project coordinator Taniko Adams highlights the importance of this exchange, indicating that St. Lucia and the Bahamas share similar environments, which produce many of the same species of flora. Adams emphasized the importance of maximizing the use of these raw materials and why innovation is critical when exploiting the value chain.
We came in with a group of 8 in total, and the objective of this overall exchange is to share the knowledge that we are doing in the Bahamas with our local craft through our local palm, which is called silver palm, and sharing of knowledge from your winemaking from the Latanye also. So over the course of the 3 days that we were training, we met with a number of your artisans from across St. Lucia. And we would have shared our local plotting through our artisans, Ms. Norman Knowles and Jerusha Knowles. They shared on different ways that they can use the Latanye, exploring, using innovation, creativity, to make sure that they use all of the resources. We've discovered that a number of your artisans are just using a portion of the Latanye and discarding. And we have a representative in the person of Ms. Pelicanos who will be shared about the importance of taking use of the full value chain to benefit them in the long run. And so because they are similar in living in the same similar communities as we have rural communities, we want to ensure that through sustainable livelihood, they can sustain with the natural resources that exist in their areas.
National Project Coordinator for the Global Environment Fund Southeast Coast Project, John Calix, reveals that St. Lucian crafters from all over the island benefited from increased knowledge and skill sets in fully exploiting the Latanye plant.
Essentially, the training centered around the Latanye plant in St. Lucia. In the Bahamas, there's a cousin which they call the silver palm. But in the Bahamas, the silver palm is used to make different craft items like bags and hats and belts, etc. But as you know, in St. Lucia, we only use the Latanye for Latanye wine and for the brooms. So the thinking was, you know, is it possible for the Latanye plant to be used for crafting other items? So the exchange was basically to see whether that was possible. Working with the artisans from, well, all over the country, from Swazelle, Lavery, PI, and even from Babano, the artisans were taught basic crafting methods, which would have been used, you know, with the Latanye plant. And what they found was that the Latanye can actually be used to make some of these craft items.
Calix believes that with its newly found popularity, the Latanye plant will be in high demand.
The plant is available, but if you're going to be now going into additional craft items, it means that you now have to kind of increase the supply of these plants. So it provides an opportunity because now you can have people who can now plant the Latanye and then, you know, sell it to the crafters, you know, for the craft makers. So yes, with the forestry department, they will be able to assist these new entrepreneurs with the Latanye plants, provide some assistance in growing the plants, and ensure that it is sustainably used for the craft making industry.
Calix says despite some minor differences to what St. Lucian artisans are used to, the Latanye plant has proven to be versatile in its offerings and aids in St. Lucia's bid to increase sustainable livelihoods. For the DBS News World, Jason Darius reporting.